Today we are going to start study of inorganic steel and iron. Before going to start to study of the periodic table, in the periodic table we have studied the iron in the row, in the fifth, that is the iron, in the you can study the basic requirement. So content of the iron in the form of the in the periodic table, in the row of the 6B, the iron, rubidium, osmium and hafnium. In the today going to start of the iron with the content maximum is the most important application to study of the iron. So in the content of the iron in the form of the content maximum content is the different salt. Like different salt depending upon this applicable of the iron in the form of this maximum applicable either to study of the aeroplanes, study of the different building blocks, the very important use of the iron content. So the iron is the basic requirement to study the maximum content in the form of the pure iron in the form of the content. The iron is the 25 and mass number. The study of the iron in the form of the Fe2O3. So this content in the form in the study. The basic requirement to study of the iron steel. The basic requirement of the steel is the manufacture. Depending of the higher content of the iron is the different content of the study in the content of the carbon, nickel, as well as the colored steel can be formed. So you can study the iron in the content of the iron in the form of this iron oxide, in the occurrence in the form of the different content. Different content in the iron content is the occurrence in the form of the oxide. The maximum content is the magnetite in the form of the iron oxide Fe2O3 or FeO Fe2O3. In the near about the content is the 74 iron. So this magnetic salt is the form of the iron oxide. The maximum content of impurity is available. But the pure form of that 74% iron can be manufactured by the magnetic black rock. So second occurrence in the form of the oxide is the hematite red rock. The maximum content in the near about Fe2O3 70% iron in the form. The maximum hematite rock is out. Maximum near about the 960 crore tons in India. The maximum hematite rock is form in the content of the iron oxide get converted to 70% iron. So third occurrence in the form of the oxide is the limonite. The maximum content is the hydroxide content of the iron Fe2O3 in the form of the hydride near about the 60% iron in the form. So these are the occurrence in the form of the different rocks is available. In the magnetite rock, second one the hematite rock, and third one the limonite rock. The in India, the manufacture of the iron is the maximum near about the 960 crore tons in India. The maximum hematite rock is available in the open area. So in the form of the content is the 70%. So this impure salt in the hematite rock, the oxidized, get converted to the maximum content of the iron can be manufactured. So in the second form, the iron can be absorbed. Occurs in the form of the carbonate. So this carbonate in the form of the citrate or septic iron ore near about this 40 to 50% iron content in the form of the iron carbonate. The second is the maximum content can be manufactured by this occurrence in the form of the carbonatic mixture of the iron carbonate. Iron content is near about the 40%, not easily separated by this carbonate iron. And third is the sulfide content of the iron can be manufactured by the occurrence in the form of the three different rocks. One is the iron pyrite Fe2, its yellow metallic rock can be found. Second one the copper content, copper pyrite CuFeS2, and third one the arsenial pyrite. In the occurrence in the form of the three content, one is the oxide, second one the carbonate, and third one the sulfide oxide. So these contain the maximum content in the occurrence in the form of the hematite rock. So how to separate these rocks in the form of the maximum content that can be manufactured by the occurrence in the content of the Fe2O3. The content is the 70% can be manufactured. So this separation of the oxides can be separated by the different content in the form of the oxide, sulfide, carbonate, like that one. In the form of the oxide content, these are the three rocks. One is the limonite, one second one the hematite, and third one the content is the depending upon the maximum content. So this separation of the iron oxide, if the Fe2O3 is the 70% iron can be manufactured. They occur by this hematite rock. So how to separate? By the separation is the technique is the by the second first one is the technique is the separation in gravitational force. So second technique is the magnetic separation. So what is the magnetic separation and gravitational separation to maximum content of the oxide in the form of this iron content? The oxide is the Fe2O3. The maximum content is 70%. If first technique is the gravimetric separation, this total rock can be gravitational force to granite to each other, very very minor crystals. That time, the gravitational force can be attracted by this possible impurity can be separated, and the higher content of the iron oxide in the form of settle at bottom of this gravitational force. And second one is the magnetic separation. So magnetic separation in the form of the maximum content iron can be in the form of the oxide get converted to the magnetic separation in the two form the pulley. One is the non-magnetic pulley and second one the magnetic pulley. Like two between this belt is used, and this pure form is the magnetic rock can be emitted on granite gravitational force. Very very minute particles get converted to the small, very smaller particles. This separated to each other. This powder form is the magnetic hematite rock in the act of non-magnetic pulley. This rotate get converted to the magnetic pulley, get converted with the maximum content is separated out, and impure iron content with possible impurity can be removed. So this is the technique is the magnetic separation. So in the magnetic separation, the maximum possible impurity can be removed by the magnetic separation in the form of the hematite rock. Thus near about the 70% content can be separated by this content by the use of the magnetic pulley. So this magnetic pulley is the magnet in the form of the iron, is the maximum content of the iron can be separated. If not possible impurity is there, the powder metal is separated by the gravity magnetic separation to separate it out, and pure form is the separated. And this content is used for the different technique of this iron separation technique. The second is the carbonating mixture. In the carbonating mixture, is the near about the 40 to 50% iron content is formed. Separate. Generally, in the content of the iron in the form of the carbonate. So this iron carbonate not easily separated due to the maximum content of this iron in the form of the carbonating mixture. The higher temperature, carbonate can be removed in the form of the pure content of the iron oxide is formed, FeO. So this FeO is the maximum content of the iron oxide, easily separated to the use of this manufacture of the different cast iron can be manufactured. The third technique is the sulfide content. The maximum content of this iron in the form of the sulfide. The three contents. One is the iron pyrite in the form of the metallic crystal. These are the content near about this 80% in the form of the sulfur content. So sulfur in presence of the iron not easily separated, but the iron separate. Why the sulfur content not easily separated? Because of the iron and sulfide is the magnetic, and therefore this content is not easily separated. By this content in the form of the content, the maximum iron can be removed by the iron pyrite, that is the metallic salt. This metallic rock can be granite, gravitational force to powder form and to separate by the use of the magnetic pulley. and this separated, and to study of this higher can be content. Second, in the higher content of the sulfide, in the form of the copper sulfide, CuFeS2, the copper is a interfering radical in the presence of the iron content. The copper and iron, because of the copper is the second group radical, unstable, and in the form of this iron, in the interfering radical, not easily separated in the content of the copper pyrite, in the form of the maximum content iron can be removed by the copper. Copper is the binder. And therefore the third is the higher content in the form of this content of this iron, arsenide pyrite in the form of the maximum content is 60 to 40%. These also separated. Generally, the iron can be manufactured by occurrence in the form of the thick content. One is the oxide, three rocks, second one the carbonate, and third one the sulfide form. In the sulfide form, also three types. One is the iron pyrite, second one the copper pyrite, and third one the arsenide pyrites. So these are the maximum content of the iron can be manufactured by the occurrence in the three content. One is the oxide, second one the carbonate, and third one the sulfide. And then this technique, you can study the different separation by this technique. One is the gravitational force, and second one the magnetic separation. And these are the maximum content, the use of the maximum content in the form of the tiltrite. One is the cast iron, that it is also known as the pig iron. The content of the carbon is near about 2.52 to 5.4. Carbon content is the second. Third type is the second type is the steel. The content of the carbon near about 0.2% to 0.5% carbon can be present. Third one the wrought iron pure. That is the content of the carbon in the form of the 0.1 to 0.2%. So these are the content in the form of the iron in the separation by the cast iron, second one the steel iron, and second third one the wrought iron. What is the difference between the cast iron? The cast iron is the maximum content in the carbon. It is also known as the pig iron. The maximum content is near about the 70 or 80% iron can be manufactured, but that time the maximum impurities are there in the maximum content of the copper is present. In the case of the wrought iron, pure form of the content in the high carbon is the near about 0.1% to 2.2% carbon percentage. So maximum, the iron oxide is generally heated with the coke and lime to get in the blast furnace to get converted to the cast iron can be manufactured. So what is the technique? So technique is that the in the form of the occurrence in the maximum content of the iron oxide, the hematite rock. So this hematite rock, by the separation, by the technique is by gravitational force as well as the magnetic separation, two possible impurity can be removed, and the pure iron oxide is heated in the presence of the coke and lime, get content of the blast furnace get converted to the cast iron. So this is the technique, is the separation of the iron, the maximum content in the form of the oxide. So what is the technique? So technique is the blast furnace. So extraction is the most important steps. So what is the technique? Technique is the preliminary treatment. Second step is the reduction, it is also known as the smelting. So what is the first step? In the first step is the preliminary treatment. Preliminary treatment, you can study, that is the crushing and grinding. Second step is the concentration, and third one the calcination, it is also known as the roasting. So in first step, the pure form is the hematite rock, the near about 80% iron can be preliminary treated by the extraction of the cast iron. In the first crushing, it is also known as the grinding. This rock, this hematite rock, is the crushed very minute particle size. And this particle size is the particle size very smaller, and this particle size to concentrate. What is the technique of the concentration? The by the use of the concentration technique, the maximum possible impurity can be removed by the crushing due to the gravitational force. possible impurity, the particle free from the ion, not magnetic, easily separated, and this mixture by the concentrator. Possible impurity can be removed by due to the force of the gravimetric force. Third technique is the calcination. What is mean by the calcination? Calcination is the heating temperature is the higher. The possible impurity is in the form of the iron carbonate. For example, carbonate to heat and get converted to the iron oxide plus removal of the CO2. So this CO2, depending upon the maximum possible impurity, can be removed. CO2 in the form of the gaseous state and pure iron can be removed. So this calcination technique, it is also known as the roasting. If the temperature not easily remove the car by the crushing technique, it is also known as the grinding force. Due to the gravitational force, not easily possible impurity can be removed. The second step is the concentration. The concentration easily removed then by the technique is the iron in the form of the carbonating mixture. The higher temperature is not, lower temperature is not remove the carbonating mixture to concentrate. The possible impurity can be removed by the concentrating technique, and then this not remove the concentration, the use of the calcination. It is also known as the roasting. So roasting is the temperature goes on increases, possible impurity can be removed like the moisture, like the carbonatic gases or other gases can be removed by the calcination technique. So this is the preliminary treatment. The under the preliminary technique, the first technique is the most important in the due to the gravitational force. It is also known that by magnetic separation to grind the mixture and easily possible impurity by the remove by the crushing. It is also known as the grinding. Not easily removed by the crushing as well as the grinding mixture to concentrate this mixture and the possible impurity can be removed. Otherwise, after the concentration, not easily removed to calcination, that temperature increases, the possible gases can be removed by the technique is known as the calcination. Temperature goes on increases, possible gases can be removed. Second step is the reduction. It is known as the smelting technique. So this technique is the most important technique. The preliminary treatment not easily removed by the gravitational force, by the crushing mixture, by the concentration, as well as the by the calcination. The most important technique is the magnetic separation. So what is the role of the magnetic separation? It is known as the magnetic characters. The by the not preliminary treatment, the by the crushing, not the concentration or calcination technique, not possible impurity can be removed, then use of the magnetic separation. So what is the technique of the magnetic separation? Technique of the magnetic separation, non-magnetic material can be removed and magnetic separation can be removed. The use of the two pulleys. One is the magnetic pulley and second one the non-magnetic pulleys. Non-magnetic pulley is easily separated in the form of the different mineral crystal, non-magnetic separation and magnetic separation. So this technique is known as the magnetic separation technique and second one the reworking process. So this is the most important to study of the iron content in the iron ore, that is the blast furnace. So what is the technique? The blast furnace is the technique. The separation, the first is the preliminary treatment, one is the crushing, second one the calcination, and third one the concentration, third on the calcination. It is also known as the roasting. If not easily removed, the use of the second technique. The second step is the magnetic separation and second one the reworking furnace. By the magnetic separation, the possible impurities are the magnetic in the content, iron in the magnetic content in the form of the iron carbonate, in the form of the iron oxide, in the form of the sulfide, in the form of the pyrite content. In content is the iron ore plus coke and laminous material. The powder material at the cone, at the top of this furnace. Before passing this content, the powder form, this is the reverse chimney shape, the material can be introduced at the top of this blast furnace. Before starting, addition of this content of the iron ore, coke, laminous by hot gases can be removed, hot waste gases can be removed. The temperature near about the 200 degrees Celsius. The temperature is near about 200 degrees at the top of this furnace is the 400 degrees Celsius. Before passing this content, the iron completely primary treatment, that is the crushing, it is also known as the grinding, to calcium concentration this mixture and then calcinate. Not easily remove this preliminary treatment, second treatment by the magnetic separation, pure form transferred to the blast furnace. The before passing this material, the temperature is starting near about 200 degrees Celsius by the hot air blast. So what is the technique? Hot air blast. So technique is the hot air blast is the temperature is the blast easily. Temperature is the create maximum at the bottom of this furnace, blast furnace. And temperature is a near about the 2000 degrees Celsius. The introducing mixture of the iron ore, coke and limestone material, the temperature at the top of this furnace 400 degrees Celsius. The temper separation, the study of the iron content is the three content, zone contents. The this content is the first content is the different chemical reaction can be carried out. So what are different chemical reactions? The iron in the form of the oxide content is the maximum, is the three content of the iron Fe2 in the react with the carbon monoxide. The maximum content is the Fe3O4 and that content is carbon dioxide can be used. If the preliminary treatment is the possible content in the form of the occurrence is the maximum content, iron Fe2O3, the temperature goes on increases by the not first treatment, is the preliminary treatment not easily separated, second treatment is not magnetic separation, then this technique we are used. The different chemical reaction, the maximum CO2 can be over. If content of the iron in the form of the Fe3O4, the maximum content of the unreactive material is the zone of the reduction, that is the CO in the form of the FeO. So what is the difference between the two? In the form of this iron oxide, FeO oxide, the CO2 can be over. The content of this Fe2O3, the red content and this content is all different. Not easily separated is the iron oxide get converted to this Fe ions. And the, in the form of the oxide, FeO, again react with the carbon monoxide and pure form of the iron can be removed. That time some content of the carbon dioxide is used. That time different impurities are there. Which are impurities? One is the maximum content of the other material in the hematite rock is the calcium. In the form of the calcium, how to remove this calcium impurity? So the calcination of the calcium carbonate temperature goes on increases. Suppose the calcium CO3, calcium oxide, heat at higher temperature near about the 800 degrees Celsius, then convert to the calcium oxide plus CO2. CO2 gas can be used. That the content of the iron in the form of the Fe2O3 and maximum content of the carbon, and then the maximum content of the iron can be removed, Fe to Fe, and that time carbon monoxide can be used. The reaction between the calcium carbonate and iron oxide, that time the calcium oxide is the lime is reacted with the content of the silica, get converting calcium silicate in the form of the slag. At the surface of this manufacturer blast furnace is the content of this slag. Slag it is known as the at the layer of this surface, the maximum temperature near about the 200 degrees Celsius. That time This lead is easily removed. And then this silica can be reacted with the carbon, get converted to the silica and carbon monoxide. That the calcium carbonate in the form of the lime, and this lime in the under content of the silica get converted to the slag, and this slag at the surface of the molten material of the iron content. That time, the content of the other impurity in the form of the manganese oxide, the higher content is the cast iron, is the content of the carbon is near about 2.5 to 5%. That time, the manganese oxide get reacted with the carbon, get total removal of the manganese plus carbon monoxide. That time, the impurity in the form of the lime, in the form of the slag, and iron content and free of the silica get converted to the unreacted carbon, react with the excess of the oxygen, get converted to the carbon monoxide. So this carbon monoxide repeated to reaction between the iron in the form of the Fe2O3, in the form of the Fe3O4, and in the form of the Fe, and this reaction again and again. So maximum content can be manufactured by the use of the blast furnace. Function of the blast furnace is the three zones. One is the zone of reduction. Zone of reduction, there are the different reaction when the in the form of the iron oxide get converted to this Fe2O3, we react with the carbon, temperature should be maintained 300 degrees Celsius, get converted to maximum. Temperature is increased in the form of the iron oxide, again temperature increase in the pure form of the iron. Limestone decompose, get converted to this oxide. Heat, zone of heat of absorption, temperature near about the Fe2O3, react with the carbon content, the maximum content of the iron, and loss of energy can be removed. That time, carbon monoxide can convert react at higher temperature. Due to temperature near about 100 degrees Celsius, carbon can be removed. And in the different chemical reaction, the lime combines with the produce to the different slags. In the slag is the high calcium, in the form of calcium oxide. That can pure Fe2O3. Iron is the reactive with carbon monoxide get converted to Fe2O3 in the form of the another impurity is the manganese oxide Mn plus carbon monoxide in the form of the silica can be react pure form. And this content of this calcium phosphate and get converted to the lime, and the possible impurity can be removed in the form of the phosphorus pentoxide react with carbon. Maximum content of phosphorus can be removed at temperature near about the 800 degrees Celsius to 1200 degrees Celsius. And last zone is the zone of fusion. Temperature is higher near about 1200 degrees Celsius to 1500 degrees Celsius. So this zone is of a fusion. The temperature should be maintained by the different chemical reaction in the form of this content temperature near about the 1200 degrees Celsius to the 1500 degrees Celsius. So function of this blast furnace, temperature should be maintained as possible as in above the 1500 degrees Celsius due to this blast. Therefore this technique is known as the blast furnace.